issue in terms of quality of the articles. Also some areas of conflict that we can find in this particular region. And we'll end up with some lesson learned, I would say, and if we have some minutes at the end for some questions. So first of all, what is a wiki project? So wiki project is a group of contributors that decides to work on a specific topic within Wikipedia, and they can build a specific space in the encyclopedia where they can develop their activities, so they can coordinate, they can discuss different items that are related to the topic, and they can in general organize their activity. So some examples here, they can develop subject-specific criteria, for example, for the admission of articles. They can organize themselves to track the work that needs to be done, for example, articles that need to be created, articles that need to be translated, etc. And of course, they can use this space to act as a forum, and where they can talk about what they are doing. They can ask questions, typically for the new contributors, and they can receive advice from more senior contributors. So of course, a wiki project is defined based on the specific topic, but depending on the articles that you want to work on, then of course you can have some projects collaborating. So, as I said, what a wiki project is, it's not only a collection of processes or templates or rules. This is really what I call a social construct. So this is really all about interaction of the contributors, how they work together, how they try to help each other. So really, these interactions, and we talked this morning about social media, this interaction is really a key in the success of wiki projects. So the goal of the project is not only to foster interest in the topic, but to also, as I said, build an esprit de corps, so really a cohesion in the group. Now, if you look specifically in the grammar, so of course, as any contributor to Wikipedia, they can contribute to any version of the encyclopedia, which is the best for them. In Maghreb, of course, Arabic is the official language in all of the countries, and we also speak Berber languages in most of them, and French as well due to colonial heritage. So we think, first, that in most of the cases, the contributors from the Maghreb will contribute in Arabic. And that's not exactly what the statistics are showing. So the table that you have below is coming from the Wikimedia Traffic Analysis report. And you have the link there so you can see for other countries if you're interested. And what we see, so this is, these data are the percentage of views from the different countries where they are going to search for Wikipedia information. And we could consider that if they go in a certain version, they have a chance to contribute in that version. So we see two different groups, actually. So first of all, you have Libya, where you can see that in 2014, 73% of the views from that country were going to the Arabic Wikipedia, 22% in English, and nothing in French or really marginal. So this is an example that would fit the hypothesis that people contribute in their own native language. Then there is another group that is composed of Algeria and Morocco, where you can see that we have a relative majority of contributors that go to the Arabic Wikipedia, but you have a strong contribution in the French version as well. We can see 37%. And then around 10 to 11% in English. So here, we still have a majority going to the Arabic Wikipedia, but this majority is reduced compared to Libya. And then you have the last group, which is composed of Mauritania and Tunisia, where you can see that in these cases we have again a relative majority of contributors that go to the French Wikipedia. So 41% in Mauritania, 47%, so nearly the half of them in Tunisia. Arabic is behind 34%, and then we see English as well, 14-15%. So really within the same region, within different countries that you could consider are similar or in the same language situation, you have very different attitudes throughout the Wikipedia and which version they are using. So in this context, the countries in general on Wikipedia are a common area of interest for the contributors, and agreement in this aspect is no different. So as of 2015, you can find wiki projects on each of the country in Arabic, English and French, which is consistent with what we have just seen. If you're interested, you could find a project on India and Morocco in Georgian, a project on Morocco in Persian, and a project on Tunisia in Spanish as well. One note here at the bottom that is interesting, only the French Wikipedia as a project that is working on Maghreb as a whole, as a region, and not only on the specific countries. So, as I said in the introductions, one of the goals of Wiki project is to help contributors in their daily contributions. So one of the aspects of Wiki project is to provide tools and templates for the project that are really specific to the need of the contributors. So you have templates, as I said, that can help to put recurring messages or TPV navigation boxes to go through different set of articles. And you can also put in place on logs as well, if you have contributors that are familiar with them, to take care of recurring tasks. So TPV and Wiki projects, updating lists, capturing new articles, this is a task that can be time-consuming and a bit boring, actually. So having both defined can really be a help in this matter to try to help the contributors focusing on really the contributions. So out of the usual tools and templates that you can find pretty much on any wiki projects, here I've put a list of some interesting tools that we can find on wiki projects working on Maghreb. So for example, on the wiki projects in Algeria and Arabic, you have specific workshops that are dedicated to some specific subjects, so the contributors can really work together on specific articles. Still wiki projects Algeria, but this time in French, you have a coordination page for the Wiki Earth Amendments contest to build up the amendments list, which is a key for this contest. You can also find some list of popular articles. So here I've taken the example of the Wiki project Morocco in English, but you can find it on some others. This is basically a note that is giving you the level of views for different articles. So you could consider that an article that is very popular might need more attention. You also have an award, for example, on the Wiki project Tunisian Arabic, that is there to try to encourage contributions. So for example, if you see that another user has made something really positive, you can put this award. Of course, this is just a virtual award, but at least this creates an atmosphere of coordination and helps to work together. And two other examples, on the Wiki project Tunisia in French this time, you have a dedicated page to request pictures. Typically, you are working on an article on a specific city or specific place, and you have no picture available, and you can take it yourself. And you can put a request on this page, and hopefully someone will have the opportunity to take this picture and share it on the comments. And the last example, still from the same project, a bibliography that has been built from the libraries of the contributors. So basically all the contributors of the project put all the list of books that they have on this topic, obviously, so that if someone needs one of these books, he knows that he can reach out to another contributor and get the references that he needs. So, as I said earlier, the Wikipedia have really social constructions. So the interactions is really a key for the success. One of the ways to maintain this interaction is to have regular communications and updates. This can be done through newsletters for those projects that are really developed. It can be simply conversation between the members on any topic that is related to the project. And this is really an effective way to bring unity and also to help develop the number of articles and the quality of the articles, because people are not fighting each other, they are helping each other. So how can you measure the level of interactions? That's a bit difficult, because you have numerous ways to communicate in Wikipedia. You can go through personal discussion pages, but most of the cases you can look at the discussion page of the project, which is basically the forum where all the contributors can discuss so that everyone is aware of what's going on. So if we look at the Wiki projects in Maghreb, what level of interactions we can see only from these discussion pages? So here I looked at these pages in the first quarter of this year. And what do we see? So the numbers that you are seeing here are the number of messages that have been posted on these discussion pages for each of the projects in each of the three main languages. What we can see, first of all, in Arabic. For the Maghreb, there is no wiki project, so that's easy. For Algeria, there is a discussion page, but there has been no message during this period. And if you look at Libya, Mauritania, Morocco, and Tunisia, not applicable, simply because there is no dedicated discussion page. All of them are redirected to the discussion page of the wiki projects on the Arab world, which doesn't mean that there is no discussion at all, but it's obvious that it's more difficult to interact specifically on a dedicated country. If you look at English, that's a bit better, but not so much. So you have four messages on the Algeria discussion page and one message on all the other, but it was actually a good message. So not really an interaction, actually. So if you look at the French version, that's where you can find the most interaction. So you can see on the Maghreb Wiki project, we have 39 messages put. For Algeria 24, for Morocco 42, and for Tunisia 62. For Libya and Mauritania, which are really small projects, here again the page is redirected to the Maghreb page this time. So obviously we have more interactions on the French version. So of course these wiki projects are built to develop the number of articles on the topic, but they also try to enhance the quality of the articles. And one way to look at this quality, to measure it, is to see how many features or good articles are currently existing from these different countries. And you can see here the numbers for each of the country and for each of the language. So the record is for Tunisia in French, you have 41 featured all good articles developed, and then you have 16 of them for Libya in English, and 13 of them for Morocco still in English, and then you have Algeria and Morocco that have 11 ones in French for each of them. And for the other countries and languages, you have a small number of them. So you can see there is not a direct link between the interaction and the level of achievements, even though we have seen that the project that had the most message was the one in Tunisia in French, and it's also the country that has been featured article. So of course wiki projects will not be wiki projects without sometimes these conflicts. And of course, conflicts can really badly affect the contribution between the users and thus the outputs that they are trying to achieve. So here I have put some examples. So of course you have the classical personal attacks between contributors, difficulty to understand the use of references, and we spoke today about the importance to share principles with the new users. But you have also some specific areas, specific topics in Maghreb that are the sorts of conflicts. One of them, Arab versus Berber identity. Who is Arab? Who is Berber? That's really a complex question. And if you go into genetics, that's becoming even more complex. Of course, the big political conflict in the region, the Western Sahara. Is it Morocco? Is it an independent country? Is it something in between? That's also a source of conflict. Definition of political identity through history. So here I can give a specific example because this is something that I have seen very recently. If you have someone that is born in Algiers, for example, in 1920, you would say that he is born in Algiers, but in which country is it? So some people would say this is Algerian. Some people would say this is French Algeria. Some people would say it's France. So this is a typical source of conflict because of course you have different point of views. For the French, this was part of France, this was a département. For the nationalists, it was Algeria, it has always been. And for the nostalgists of France, this is French Algeria, which in French, French Algeria is really connotated. So this is just one of the examples of this kind of conflicts. And creation of maps related to Maghreb history, especially if we look at the Middle Ages, for example, you have different kingdoms, different entities that don't have really clearly defined borders. So if you try to map that, that's really a door open for conflicts. So you can use different sources that will give you different maps. So what do you do at the end? That's a bit difficult. And here I have put some examples that you can look at if you're interested. First one is an arbitration between two Maghreb users. One of them was declared himself as Moroccan, the other one as Algerian. And pretty much we covered the whole set of conflicts that you can see above, and now they have stopped to contribute to climate problem. The first country of Algeria is Bouteflika, a nice one as well. So for those of you who don't know, the Algerian president is born in Oujda, which is now in eastern Morocco. But of course he was born in 1937, before independence of both countries, so we have the same conflict as before. Oujda, is it in Morocco? Is it in France? Is it in the French protectorate of Morocco? And of course you can put the link, but put another verbiage on the link, so this is really a door open for... You can see the link, you have pretty much, I don't know how many thousands of bytes of discussion that at the end led to nothing actually. And another example that is based on the Algeria-Morocco border. So of course, I was personally involved in that one because at the beginning there was a conflict of course, Moroccan and Algerian contributors that were fighting to define where the frontier is, where the frontier has been in the past centuries, and they were just destroying references to one to another. So I was called as an agent to try to find a solution, and actually it only took me like an hour to just summarize all the references that they had used to have a common neutral version of it. So this is possible. So the substance of this reduce, of course, we should encourage contributors to create weekly projects or to make them alive if some of them are not really active, because this is really a leverage to help the contributors that they are not alone in their contributions, they can count on some other users. Contributions should be promoted, so we have seen in the examples that you can have wars between projects or between users because they try to defend your personal topic versus the other ones. While typically on projects on Maghreb, you can have a lot of topics that you can work that are really transnational that can have benefit from the help of each person. Then you have a role of something I call the coordinator. This is really someone that will be willing to help in maintaining a wiki project. So typically this is what I call the Tunisia project in French, which means to make sure that the pages are updated, if there is these articles to be created, to remove those that have been created. So, and we try to encourage people like to participate in contests, to really evolve, that not necessarily successful all the time, but at least you create an environment that is available to contributions. And of course, trying to, at the same time, to cut down the conflict as early as possible. Typically, in the example that we have seen, this has gone for weeks, sometimes months. So of course, when it's really advanced, it's difficult to stop a conflict right now, except by blocking the different users. So really addressing this as early as possible, but it means that we have, you have contributors that look at the articles and can intervene quickly. And of course, having automated solution as much as possible for any recurrent tasks to try to limit what is really redundant and not really value added, and to focus on the contributions. Do you have any questions, any comments?
What makes a successful wiki project?
That's a good question. I would say first ingredient for me is to have, as I said, an atmosphere that is encouraging people or guiding people towards contributions. I know that when you are new contributors, you can easily, how could I say that? You can be really shocked by someone reverting you, for example.
Yeah.
That can happen. So it's really trying to explain each time to the contributors why the contribution is not appropriate and how well they can do to enhance it as much as possible. The second ingredient I would say is really to have this esprit de corps that I mentioned. So really having all the contributors not only willing to work together, but also not being closed to the other projects, because you can typically imagine that you can defend your projects and forget what is outside of it, which is always a possible defeat. So I think that's it. It's really, we talked this morning about the introducing principles to newcomers. I think it's very important, because a lot of potential contributors are stuck because they don't understand the rules, the basics, and when someone reverts them or cancels their contributions, they say, okay, they don't want my contributions, first off. So really the key for me is, at least on the minor projects that I do regularly, is the importance of the references and not the quality of the references, which is something that we can see on Wikipedia as well.
Thank you very much, Murat. So we have time.